Most women can only dream of a multiple orgasm, but for Amanda Grice, it's a living nightmare. The 22-year-old suffers from a rare condition, which means she has 50 uncontrollable orgasms every day, which can happen any time and anywhere.
Do you need a moment?
Sorry. Instead of being a beautiful thing like it's supposed to be, it would start becoming more of a nuisance.
There is currently no medical explanation or cure, so Amanda has to keep active through yoga and the gym just to find relief. Amanda has had her life turned upside down by the condition called persistent sexual arousal syndrome.
Pleasure is supposed to be a good thing, but when you have it for too long, it's like eating a lot of candy, something that's really good and makes you really happy, but then you start getting sick from it because you had so much. And usually at this point I'd be crying by now.
Her orgasms, or tics, can be triggered by the smallest vibration, even from a car journey.
Exactly.
Okay.
Wow. So the vibration's going through the car just from the road. I can feel it onsetting my tics.
Amanda's unusual condition developed when she was just 8 years old, and it became so bad she even considered suicide. But it is only recently that she's had the courage to talk to her family, including older sister Crystal.
It makes me sad to know that she would want to kill herself because of this.
Amanda has been to 4 doctors, but was dismayed when none had heard of the condition. Today she's visiting sex therapist Crystal Hollenbeck to try and get more information.
You're the first person that I know of that I've been in contact in the area that has any knowledge of this. So I'm just looking to get a little bit more information.
My recommendation with you would just be to continue seeking medical treatment, continue with counseling. Yeah. Hopefully you're going to continue to get some symptom relief and learn how to manage the symptoms more than it overwhelming you every day. Enjoy your day.
Me too. I'm very much excited. I can now process moving forward to the next step, and that is finding medical treatment and help for my disorder.
Amanda has taken her search for answers online, where she's been able to discuss her condition with people from all over the world.
I won't stop speaking and raising awareness on this until something's done about it, and until it's taken seriously, not only in my country, but in the entire world.